Oh, hey, you are up early. You never went to bed. Baby, this is the third time this month, and we are not even halfway through it. I know you love researching, and that it doesn't feel like work to you, but you have to stop at some point. And I know you won't do it yourself, so I'm asking you, please go to bed. Of course, you aren't tired. You consume what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 Red Bulls. I'm surprised your heart hasn't exploded yet. Oh, only 4 from last night. That's so much better. Look, you are going to shut your computer down right now. And you are coming to bed with me, okay? I don't care if a batch of files just finish. You are done working. If I let you through those, then you are going to have to prep a new branch. Then you will want to analyze each file to see what went wrong. And then it will be 2 PM and you still haven't slept. No. Stop arguing. You are going to sleep now. Or else what? Oh, you don't want to know what is. So, you know how I got a package yesterday. Yeah, I got a handheld vacuum cleaner because it's easier to use for getting into narrow spots. But I can think of a second use for it. Oh, no, I would. Do you want to test that assumption? Alright, if... Oh! Change your mind? Yeah, I thought so. Good kitty. Oh, you don't like being called that. What about good Neko? Oh, you are so cute when you try to act like you are scary. Look at me, I'm gonna poof myself up and swish my tail back and forth, cause I'm so mad. I'm a big scary Neko. I'm not an adorable kitty cat. No, and you aren't intimidating. You're like a big stuffed animal. Well, if you didn't insist on acting like a child, I wouldn't have to treat you like one. Look, I'm just worried about you, about your health. Yeah, that's kind of my point. You have too much willpower. You will push past early stages of burnout until you are 6 feet under trying to swim through land. No, you are not ni Natasha ni Anders. You don't have to be invincible. I know you want to be, sweetie, but you don't have to set yourself on fire to keep others warm. You can be a great researcher without sacrificing yourself. I know it feels like you have to, by constantly asking you for updates, but that's to keep you moving forward, not to push you faster. You are allowed to have a break. Yep, you are exhausted. You didn't even catch my double entendre. Come on, let's get you to bed. Nice and soft bed. Come on. lie down next to me. There you go. And now I wrap my arms around you like this. And now we are wrapped up like a furry burrito. Come on, arms around me. Good kitty. Oh, I know you love me calling you that. You pretend you don't, but I see your ears perk up. Can't hide anything from me. Your subconscious betrays you. Hmm? What? Yeah, of course you can talk to me. But first I want to say that I'm really proud of you for doing so. Usually I have to pry emotions out of you. So, what's up? Of course I'm proud of you. You are doing a great work and found something you are passionate about. Who cares if you are stuck? You are a student. You are not supposed to be producing solutions as fast as professionals. Otherwise, you would be dead already. Don't worry about hitting roadblocks. You can't avoid them. Just have to accept them as a part of researching and keep your head up. Wait, is that why you have been staying up so late? Kitty. No. Come here. I know it's scary when nothing's working. Imposter syndrome sets in, and you feel compelled to keep working. But you don't have to. You already work enough during the day. Nighttime should be for you to rest, for you to relax. I know it's hard, but that's why I'm here, right? I'm here to remind you it's okay to stop. Are you headbutting me? Why? Oh, you want the screeches, don't you? All right, here. Yeah, I know you like it. Right there. Right behind your fluffy ears. God, your ears are so fluffy. Who is the best kitty in the world? It's you, yes. You are such a good, good kitty. It's so cute when you nuzzle into my hands like that, purring like a little giant. You seem so blissful, content, melted into a puddle. You know, we could do this more often. It could be a nice break for both of us. But I know you have to get back to work. How about this? If you sleep for an hour, I will let you work on that batch of files that just finished. You don't want to now? What changed? Oh, I wasn't giving you headbutts then. So, you're telling me that if I ever want you to do something, I just have to scratch your ears a little bit? Oh, yes. I couldn't abuse your love of pets for that. Now, close your eyes, okay? Good kitty.